Hey guys, so today we're going to be going over the installation of a wheel adapter. To do this job, you just need some basic hand tools. You'll need some sockets, a breaker bar, and a torque wrench. Now, before starting this job, you want to have the vehicle properly supported on level ground on axle stands. Technically today, I'm installing a wheel spacer with lugs on it, but it's the exact same concept as a wheel adapter. The only difference is I'm not changing the bolt pattern on this vehicle. Now, to do a wheel spacer install, it's like installing a wheel twice. So, if you want to watch this video here, you can watch one of my angels change a wheel, or we can keep watching this video and watch me install the wheel spacer. So what you might notice is I put some anti-seize compound onto the drum itself. Now the reason why I did that is when you have two pieces of metal that are different materials like aluminum and steel and you're going to have them against each other for a long period of time, they tend to seize together. So we're just going to put some only on the mating surfaces, so if you ever have to service this later down the road, you're going to have an easier time taking it all apart. So this is my wheel adapter, and you always want to buy from a credible brand that uses the highest quality materials available on the market. Now this one is bought exactly the spec. I had it machined by them. So you can see here on this diameter, that's exactly the exact same diameter as the factory hub. And over here, this is machined out to replicate the factory hub again. That way you're mounting your wheels hub centric. Now another thing I want to mention before you put on your wheel spacer or wheel adapter is you probably want to put on a little bit of thread lock. Now this is blue, you want to be using red. This is just a prop, get over it. You want to put a little bit on the threads, that way those nuts aren't going to back off over time. I would recommend checking them every once in a while, but some people are lazy, so take the extra precaution. So I'm going to put the wheel adapter on now. I'm not putting thread lock on because I'm going to be servicing this again. I'm just doing this as a demonstration, so don't freak out that I'm not putting thread lock, even though I just told you to put on thread lock. So we're going to just put this on here. Now, before you torque this to spec, you want to work all the lug nuts on by hand. This way you avoid any chance of cross-threading anything. Next, you're going to tighten the lug nuts down to the manufacturer's specification. You're going to do this in a crisscross pattern. Another major thing you have to consider when you're doing this style of wheel adapter is you have to make sure that the factory lug doesn't go longer than the actual material, or else your wheel's not going to mate properly to the surface. So in my case, I got lucky and it isn't, so the wheel's going to fit on fine. But in a lot of applications, sometimes you have to cut this to make this fit. Okay, we're going to install our wheel now. It's the exact same procedure as before. Now this part right here, you want to be really careful when you're putting the wheel on because you don't want to chip that because that is still aluminum. And again, before we torque our lug nuts down to spec, we're going to start it all by hand to avoid cross-threading. We just got them all snug down by hand, and go ahead and torque them to spec. And again, crisscross pattern. Now that that's all done, put on your fishing cap. And once you're all done, hopefully you have the offset that you're all looking for. Now, keep in mind, like I suggested before, always buy from a credible brand, because these parts actually have a lot of forces going on them. So you don't want something that's going to break easily. And hopefully today you learned on how to install these and how easy it is, but the little things that you have to look for when you're actually installing them. We'll be right back.
Thank you.